Hello students, in today's lecture we'll be starting with trigonometry. This is the most interesting chapter of your whole portion. Apart from your circle and similarity, it is good chapter, practical based. इसमें ज़्यादा टू प्रूफ वगैरह नहीं आएगा, ऑल्टरनेट एंगल्स, करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स तुम्हें परेशान करने के लिए नहीं आएंगे. So you remember the basic formulas of trigonometry done in previous year?
Yes.
What are the ratios?
Sine, cos,
sine theta. Okay, we'll go. Sine theta. What is sine theta?
Opposite.
Sine theta is
opposite of hypotenuse.
In reference to a right angle triangle. Suppose this is unknown angle theta. So sine theta is opposite upon hypotenuse.
AB upon.
We'll do that later on in next exercise. Okay, what is cos theta?
Adjacent upon hypotenuse.
Opposite side upon
hypotenuse.
Tan theta is opposite upon adjacent, and the remaining ratios in ke ulte ulte. Cot theta is
opposite.
Cos ka ulta
hypotenuse.
These are the basic formulas, you remember?
Yes.
Then we had trigonometric table also of values. Zero, 30. We'll do that later on. बाद में revise करेंगे. First exercise में it's not needed. Just write this formula and then we'll start with the first part. In first exercise, we need to know some concepts. First is directed angle. Now we know what is an angle. It has two rays. But you do not know which is initial arm and which is terminal arm. Okay. Now what is a directed angle basically? Suppose this is the base ray of the angle. ये इतना turn हुआ, incline हुआ और ray यहाँ पे पहुँचा. तो इसको directed angle बोलते हैं. That's it. जितना inclination हुआ उसको बोलते हैं directed angle. So all the angles are directed angles. Because either they move upwards or they will move downwards. कैसे भी हो सकता है. So that's the definition of directed angle. Initial arm. The base of the angle is called initial arm. यहाँ से angle start होता है ray OA. Then you turn it, it reaches to suppose ray OB. तो ray OB is called terminal. So angle has two arms, initial arm and terminal. Now how do we use this in graph, which is called a standard angle? Now we all know a Cartesian plane. What is a Cartesian plane?
XY
coordinate वाला. So this is x dash. Y dash. So for standard angle, the initial arm of the angle will always lie on positive x-axis. तुमने question में कभी mention किया हो angle in standard position, मतलब उसका initial arm lies on positive x-axis. And then यहाँ से वो ये side जा सकता है या फिर ये side जा सकता है. In plane we always assume the angle will start from positive x-axis. Okay. That's it. So initial arm का definition लिखो. Directed angle not needed. Initial arm. Draw this diagram. Ray OA is initial arm of angle AOB. Ray OA is initial arm of angle AOB. Then next concept is terminal arm. Ray OA rotates and becomes terminal arm, that is ray OB. Hence we get angle AOB. Next is standard angle. or it is also known as angle in standard position. In Cartesian plane, initial arm lies on positive x-axis, which is called angle in standard position. Suppose initial arm itna rotate hua. Angle in
positive
x-axis. Draw this diagram. With reference to this diagram, what is the initial arm over here? Ray, OR, and what is the terminal arm?
OP.
So right. For angle POR, ray OR is initial arm, ray OP is terminal arm. Next concept we have, when the measure of angle is positive and when the measure of angle is negative. Now we'll always assume it with a reference to a Cartesian plane. Initial arm will always lie on positive x-axis. So this is your initial arm over here, suppose ray OA. It moves in this direction. So isko kya bolenge? Anti-clockwise bologe? Ulta, clock se ulta ja raha hai. So this is called anti-clockwise direction. Agar ye niche rotate hota hai, to ye kaun se direction mein ja raha hai? Normal. Clock ke direction mein ja raha hai, to isko clockwise direction bolte hai. Now, if the angle rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the measure is positive. And if the angle rotates in clockwise direction, the angle is negative. So suppose yahan pe agar measure 30 degree hai, so this will be positive 30. Aur agar yahan pe measure 30 hai, so this is
negative
30. Okay. So write the definition. Positive angle. If the initial arm rotates in anti-clockwise direction, the measure is positive. Example, measure angle POA equals to 30 degrees. Next, negative angle. If the initial arm rotates in clockwise direction, the measure of angle is negative. Example, measure angle POQ equals to minus. Okay, next concept is angles in quadrant. Now, we know that initial arm always lies on positive x-axis. Yahan se rotate hokar, terminal arm jahan pe pahunchta hai, the angle is said to be in that quadrant. Suppose, again, ray OP is your initial arm. They rotate hua anti-clockwise direction and suppose terminal arm yahan pe pahuncha. Suppose ray OQ. So, angle POQ is said to be in second quadrant. Okay? We are not concerned with the initial arm. Initial arm will always lie on positive x-axis. The place where terminal arm lies is important for the position of the angle. Suppose it rotates in clockwise direction and terminal arm reaches over here. So angle POR is said to be in fourth quadrant. We all remember the quadrants first of all?
Yes.
First, second, third, fourth. We have done it in previous standard. Let's mention it. First, second, third and fourth. Okay? only the position of terminal arm is important. Ye ek marka question aata hai exam. So right, the definition of angles in quadrant. The quadrant in which terminal arm lies. The quadrant in which terminal arm lies. Angle is said to be in that quadrant. Angle is said to be in that quadrant. Example we'll write. Angle POQ lies in which quadrant? Second. Angle POR lies in fourth quadrant. Now next concept is measure of angle in a quadrant. What are the possible measures of the angle if they lie in any of the quadrant? Okay. Start कहाँ से करेंगे? We start from positive x axis. Initial arm यहाँ पे है. तो measure क्या होगा angle का यहाँ पे?
Zero.
कोई deviation नहीं है. There's nothing. We have only one arm. So angle measures 0 degree. यहाँ से I move here. What will the measure over here?
90.
Now look again. We are talking about anti-clockwise direction. इसलिए measure positive है. We are moving उल्टा. Clockwise से उल्टा move करते हैं. So measure था positive. 90 है. यहाँ पे आए तो
180.
यहाँ पे आए तो
negative.
We are still moving in anti-clockwise.
Minus
270. Plus 90 ना? 90 plus करोगे हर एक. और यहाँ पे पूरा रोटेट होते हैं 360. सो ये हो गया एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. नाउ इफ वी स्टेट द सेम थिंग इन क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन व्हाट विल बी द मेजर्स? डेफिनेटली द मेजर्स विल बी इन माइनस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अगेन. माय इनिशियल आर्म लाइज हियर ऑन positive x-axis, okay? It's moving in anti-clockwise direction. यहाँ पे पहुँचेगा तो
minus 90.
Minus 90. यहाँ पे
minus
180.
Minus 180.
Minus 270.
And here
minus 360.
यहाँ से start किया था 0. So we moved in
clockwise.
Difference समझा? This is anti-clockwise and this is clockwise. So we can easily get the measure of the angles when it lies in any of the quadrant. You do not know the measure of the angle. Question कैसे आता है? The terminal arm of the angle lies in third quadrant. State what are the possible measures? तो third quadrant में है. If it moves in anti-clockwise direction, तो measure किसके बीच में होगा? 180 to 270 के बीच में. और clockwise direction में move करेगा तो -180 to -90 के बीच में. If we are not given direction, हम दोनों का answer लिखेंगे. Direction given है, well and good, एक का answer लिखेंगे. Okay? So we'll convert this into table form. First quadrant, anti-clockwise direction. Measure किसके बीच में होगा? 0 to 90 के बीच. Second quadrant, 90 to 180 के बीच. Moving to third. 180 to 270 के बीच में. एंड देन फोर्थ 270 to 360. क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन है. विल स्टार्ट अगेन फ्रॉम 0 to 90. लेकिन ये क्वाड्रेंट कौन सा है?
फोर्थ.
तो फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट में 0 to -90 -280. क्वाड्रेंट कौन सा है ये?
थर्ड.
-180 to -270 सेकेंड क्वाड्रेंट. 4th is 270 to 360. Okay, now no one asked me, what if the terminal arm lies exactly on the axis?
90 degree, 180 degree.
Question पहले आना चाहिए था दिमाग में.
270.
मैंने बोला quadrant में है in terminal arm, तो measures क्या होगा? तुम्हें समझ आ गया. But if exactly on the axis होगा, तो exact जो measure हमने लिखा वही होगा. And these angles have name quadrantal angles. So if the terminal arm lies on any of the axis, the angles are known as quadrantal angles. ये भी एक मार्क question आता है. So write the definition. When terminal arm lies either on x axis or y axis, it is called quadrantal angle. Very simple concept. We'll do 2-3 solid examples related to this.
Solid example.
I'll give my question. Okay, first question. Right. Terminal arm lies in second quadrant. What are the possible measures? What are the possible measures of angle?
90, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180, 180.
दोनों मेंशन करना पड़ेगा. I have not mentioned the direction, so you will mention both the things. Okay, so how we are going to write it? When terminal arm rotates in anti-clockwise direction, terminal arm does not rotate, initial arm rotates and reaches to become terminal arm. So just write angle. When angle rotates in anti-clockwise direction, no short forms for you, the measure of angle is between 90 to 180. Same statement for clockwise direction. When angle rotates in clockwise direction, the measure of angle is between 270 to -180.